In this video, I'm going to show you how you can use an automatic form in your VBA macro. So I have included a link to another video that I did on how to insert the automatic form button on your quick access tool button bar, but we'll go on from here. Now, this gentleman that I was working for had a large number of people working for him and a large number of places that they worked for. He was looking to have a button so that he could automatically add employees or search for employees at any time. But what I thought of is we could use the automatic form button. So let me just show you, for example, how easy the automatic form button is. So we're going to select the top rows here. We're going to go Control Shift down arrow to get to the bottom of my data. And then we're going to go get our automatic form button from our quick access toolbar here. And then, so if you wanted to add a new employee, you would just simply put new, and then you would put cameras. And active is yes. And employee is Betty Rebel. Okay, and then you go new. All right. Now, if we close this, then we go down to the bottom, and there you have Betty Rebel and Camrose. And so, what I thought I could do is I could just record this as a macro. So, what I've gone to is my developer tab. I'm going to record macro. And I'm going to record it. I'm going to call it macro 2, and it's for this workbook. And so I'm going to say OK. And so then I just go through the same steps as I just went. I go to the top, I go Control Shift down arrow, and then I go and get my automatic form button. Okay, and then I close it because we're good. And so now what I'm going to do is I'm going to stop recording my macro, and I'm going to click someplace else, and then I'm going to go to the top, and now let me run my little macro too that I have done. And when you run it, you get an error. It does not like you automatically doing a record macro to do this one. So this is the actual code that I use to get it to work. So basically we are selecting the same range, range selection, selecting down to the bottom last row. And now what we're doing is we're naming the selection. Selection name equals database. When you name the selected area, then it's quite happy to show you the active sheet. Active sheet show data form. And it is quite happy to do that. So let's run this. So what I'm going to do is people have asked me a few times, and so I'll show you. So I'm going to install a button here. And I'm going to put my new employees there. And I won't bother renaming it. And so what we're going to do is we are going to click the button. And there you get your new form to add a new person here. So that is the little trick to enable you to use the automatic form that's available to you in Excel in your VBA macros. Please subscribe.